for inviting me in this workshop. And today I'm going to talk about redundant blow-ups. And Mori Dream rational surfaces. So basically, this is a joint work with joint work in progress. With Jin-Hyung Park. Okay, so basically I will talk about the geometry of rational surfaces, just rational surfaces. And first I would like to recall the definition of Mori Dream spaces. So let X be a normal projective variety of any dimension, and then X is called a Mori Dream space. Let's say MDS, if first X is Q factorial, and the Picard group is same as Aaron-Severi group, tensor by Q, and which is finitely generated. This is the first condition. And second condition is that the Neff cone is same as semi-ample cone, which is polyhedral, so yeah. And it is polyhedral. Okay. And the last condition is that there is a finite collection of small q factorial modifications, fi, such that each xi satisfies 1 and 2. And the moving cone is a union of the pullback of the Neff cone. Okay? Sorry? Yes. Rational polyhedra. Okay, so small q factorial modification is just a birational map, which is isomorphism in codimension 1. So flips are typical examples of small q factorial modifications. Okay, so
this SQM, sorry, is this the finite collection of
small q factorial modifications.
Small
q factorial modifications. Okay, so why is it named Mori Dream? Okay. Maybe this is the first question. So, because for every divisor in X, we can run DMMP. We can run DMMP and it can be terminated. So not just Kx plus D, but any divisor D. So this is what Mori's dream comes true. So this is a Boolean space. So for example, every NEF divisor is semi-ample divisor here. Okay. So this is a general definition of Mori dream space, but today I'm only going to talk about Mori dream surfaces. Okay, this is the most base case. So if I replace this by Mori dream surfaces, then of course the last condition is vanished, because this is an isomorphism in codimension 1. So this is the condition that we need, actually. Okay. Okay, so so what are the examples of Mori dream surfaces, or generally Mori dream spaces? So first, toric varieties. This is the original work of Cox, which is a modification for...
What about the last condition, that the movable is equal to net?
Yeah, so...
Which remains.
Yes, so... consider the moving cone, then this can be decomposed into the...
No, for surfaces.
Surfaces, so I can vanish this last condition.
Only one model.
Yeah, that's
what. The property that the movable cone is the left cone.
Mm-hmm.
If that's contained in the condition and that's
yes. And this is actually a second condition.
Is ample, not semi-ample. S-ample is the
semi-ample,
right?
Yes,
semi-ample.
Okay. Then typical examples are log funnel varieties. This is a corollary of BCHM. And then some varieties with effective cis direction, cis varieties. And some K3 surfaces were Enrique surfaces with finite automorphism groups. So those are known examples of Mori dream spaces. So today I'm going to concentrate on the rational surface case.
No, so toric varieties are co-factorial, so maybe you must ask with some condition.
I don't know, maybe. Okay. For safety.
Yeah, I have a key factor that I...
Yeah, maybe, but okay.
Actually, there is a notion of Mori dream spaces without assuming Q factoriality, but I don't know much about that way, so. Okay, so now Mori dream rational surfaces. So from now on, let X be a smooth rational surface. Of course, projective. Okay. Okay, then the anti-canonical Ithaca dimension is one of the four numbers. First, so I will call this number as anti-Godard dimension for short. Okay. Okay, then first, if this dimension is 2, then it is known that every such surfaces are Guridi-Riemann rational surfaces. This is proven, this is published in 2010 by Testa, Barilli, Alvarado, Velasco, and independently by Chen, Dawei Chen, and Schnell. This paper is unpublished. Okay, then, if the anti-Godard dimension is 1, then there is a theorem by Artevani and Lafate that, assuming this, X is a Guridi-Riemann rational surface if and only if X contains finitely many minus 1 curves. If and only if the effective cone is rational polyhedral. So it is more or less very satisfactory. But if the dimension is lower than this, then not much is known, actually. So here's a paper by Lapace and Testa. So they investigated the condition when the left divisor becomes a semi-empty divisor. So they give the criterion. That left divisor becomes semi-empty. But it should be a rational polyhedral, but they didn't give the condition on the finite generalness of this NEF cone. So this is incomplete in some sense. And they also give an example. They also gave one example here. Okay, and for the final case, as far as I know, nothing is known. Okay, so this is what is known until now. So now I'm going to address the questions that I want to solve today. So first one, actually this first question is the our original aim of this work.
So an example you gave anti-dimensional.
Yes. So what's the question?
There are an examples in the yesterday where you blow up many points.
Not known yet, but I will construct it.
You will?
Yeah. So this is the question 2.
Isn't it obvious that if you blow up many points on P2, then it's minus infinity?
That, That's right, but yeah. I want to find the example with the Mori dream space.
With the?
Which is also a Mori dream space. This is hard.
Okay.
Of course, in the case, this is very. So actually, this question is addressed in the paper PVV that I mentioned here. That I mentioned there, Pesta, Varelli, Alvarado, Lasco, remark 3. So simple. So a minimal resolution of Del Petro surfaces with rational singularities is always Mori dream rational surfaces with Antikythera dimension 2. Okay. Actually, this will have always Antikythera dimension 2, and by the theorem by TVV, we know that this is Mori dream space. Okay. So the problem that was stated in this remark is the question: is the converse true? Okay, so when I first saw this remark, I thought that there will be many counterexample, but many people told me that they believe this converse is true. So this is the reason that I started this work. So yes. This one, or which one of minus k?
If have a Mori dream rational surface with that k minus k is equal to 2.
Yes.
Then the problem is to decide that minus k is net. Because then it follows. The converse means that minus k is net.
So I don't get the question. So
if minus k is nef and b,
yes,
then you get really a Del Petro surface with rational singularity.
Uh-huh.
Will be minus.
Oh, okay. But why must you monitor the space by that?
Yeah, that was my question.
If you take each of the block 100 points that line on the line.
But here, can I say, here by Del Petro, I mean just minus k is ample. Not nef, but ample.
If it's net, you contract the minus 2 curve.
Rational singularities. Yes, not rational node points.
This statement is exactly equivalent to your question.
It's not necessarily Grange time. This is not rational double point, but general rational singularities. OK. Okay then, I don't know, maybe I should proceed first. Yeah. So my theorem is that maybe this is useless, but for each integer n, there exists rational surface of Picard number n with this integral Godard dimension, which is not a minimal resolution of Tappet-Zhou surfaces. Actually, constructing this is not so difficult. So maybe. Yeah, this implies Bohrian space. Yes, by the theorem by TBV or Chenchner. Okay, and second question is this one. So there is no theoretic explanation for the Bohrian rational surfaces in this integral Godard dimension. First, I wanted to construct the examples. So for this question, we have an answer. So for each integer greater than or equal to 11, we have the examples, we constructed the examples of Bohrian rational surfaces with anti-Godard dimension 0 of that Picard number. And also, we could construct the example with anti-Godard dimension negative infinity with Picard number n plus 1. Okay. So those two are main results that I wanted to talk. So the main method of constructing those two are just blow up, called redundant blow up. So I will define what the redundant blow up is later, and then I used Zariski decomposition or some C star actions on algebraic surfaces, so on. Okay, so first I would like to explain the notion of redundant blow-ups. Okay, so to define redundant blow-ups, we have to use the Zariski decomposition. So I have to assume that the surface that I want to consider is of anti-Godard dimension at least zero. So because this condition is equivalent to say that minus kx is pseudo-effective. So we can use the Zariski composition of minus kx. Okay, so let this be the Zariski composition of minus kx. Okay, then now we define the redundant blow-ups. So a point P on x is called a redundant point. If the multiplicity of the negative part at P is at least 1, then we call the point P as a redundant point. And blow up the point P, then we get a surface X tilde, and we call this blow up as a redundant blow up. If this P is a redundant point. Okay, this is redundant blow up. And we get an exceptional divisor here, and this is called a redundant curve. Okay, so good thing about this redundant blow-up is that this blow-up doesn't change the anti-Godard dimension. So basically, this theorem is by Sakai, Fumio Sakai, that X is S above smooth rational surfaces with anti-Godard dimension at least 0. And let pi be a redundant blow-up. Then first, the anti-Godard dimension is the same. And second, we can talk about the Zariski decomposition. So minus kx tilde is p tilde plus n tilde, where p tilde is the pullback of p, and n tilde is pullback of n minus e, the redundant curve. So we already have the Zariski decomposition for minus kx here. Okay. So basically, here's a few remarks about the terminology. So basically, Sakai is the first one who defined the notion of redundant curve, but not the redundant point or redundant blow up.
Why is n tilde
then affected? I mean, n is a 2 divided, right? Yes. Because of the multiplicity is 1. Yeah. Okay. So he defined redundant curve first, but there's a little difference between his notion and yeah, so I will explain it now. So please wait for 1 minute. So actually he defined the redundant curve, Sakai's redundant curve. Redundant curve is defined by a minus one curve E with PE is 0. Okay. But if we assume this one, then we automatically get PE is 0. And also he proved that if the anti-Godard dimension is minus P tilde, right, thank you. Here also P tilde. Okay, but he only considered this redundant curve when the anti-Godard dimension is 2. And when we have this condition, then those two are equivalent. So in this case, the two notions coincide. And why is it called redundant? So basically, his aim was to study rational surfaces with anti-Godard dimension 2. So his basic theorem is like this. His main theorem is, for any x, a smooth rational surface with anti-Godard dimension 2, then take the anti-canonical model. Then we have, I don't want to define this precisely, but this is the anti-canonical model. Then he proved that this is a Calpetto surface with rational singularities, And this map can be decomposed by this map, Y. And this is a composition of redundant blow-ups. And Y doesn't contain any redundant curve. Okay, so basically if we blow up a point on Y, then we get another surface. And if it is of anti-Godard dimension 2, if we calculate the anti-canonical model, then those two are different. But if we perform only redundant blow-ups, then it does not change any anti-canonical model. So this blow-up is kind of redundant one, in the sense of this anti-canonical model. Okay? So this is why he called this as redundant curve. Okay. So this is a picture only for this one, but I want to generalize it to this case, because anyway, if minus kx is pseudo-effective, then you can use this Zariski decomposition. And if you see this theorem, then you may find that to study the structure of birational geometry here, it is very important to know the redundant points. Okay, so if we know the existence of redundant point, then we can perform the redundant blow-ups. Okay? So first, I want to talk about the redundant points.
Any kind of rational singularities generalize in this
anti-canonical model? No, because maybe I can prove that there is no Calpetto surfaces with some ADE singularities, with fixed. So I can prove this anyway. It's not easy. It's very easy. Sorry? This one or this one, or yeah, erased one?
Erased.
Yeah. So how can I say? So I can prove that there is no Calpetto surfaces with 1,000 A1 singularities. This is what I want to say.
There are some configurations.
Yeah. Right, yeah. There are some configuration that there is no Calpetto surfaces with those configuration. Yes. Only finitely many. Okay, so now I want to say how to find redundant points. Okay, so to do this, I want to use the use the knowledge on singular surfaces. So let Y be a normal projective surface with rational singularities. And let pi be its minimal resolution. Here, basic assumption is that minus k y is nef. So this is critical assumption. So lemma is we have a Zariski decomposition. Kx pi upper star minus ky plus pi is the minimal resolution. Then we get the exceptional divisors, and this is just the discrepancy. Then we have this Zariski decomposition. This is the positive part, and this is the negative part. And of course, because of this assumption, p is nef automatically, and this is negative definite because it's the exceptional divisors of the minimal resolution, and those are orthogonal.
What you're not saying is that the AI is basically equal to zero and equal to zero and equal to zero.
But this is no question, because I missed what you say. Sorry.
You made a minimal resolution.
Yes.
Those AIs are greater than or equal to zero.
Uh-huh.
They're strictly greater than zero, except for rational.
That's right. But this is rational singularity. Yes.
Got nothing to do with that.
Yeah. What you said is right. Yeah. So what Miles Reed said is there is a characterization of singularities according to this discrepancy. I should erase that first. But okay, so the main result here is we can determine the redundant point. If we look at the singularities, so X contains no redundant point, if and only if the singular surface Y contains at worst rational double point or cyclic quotient singularities of type two minus three. There is no restriction on the number of those minus two curves, and minus two minus two minus three minus two, and -2 -3 -2. -2 -4, and minus n. So this is the main result. So the proof is nothing but calculating this discrepancy. Okay, so the only thing that I have to do is to find a point with multiplicity at least one. So basic idea is that so if it is not quotient type, now the quotient type, then we have this a component like this. Then this kind of point is a redundant point. And if it's a, and this is the first step, and second step is that you can, using similar argument, you can show that can say that redundant point is on the intersection of two exceptional curves. So from now on, we can assume that the singularity is of quotient type, and we can show this. And finally, just calculate the discrepancy, then we get the answer. Okay, the discrepancy. So for example, if this is the only minus 3 curve and the others are all minus 2 curves, then this point is the redundant point. Just, it is immediately follows from the calculation of the discrepancy. Yes? Yes. Okay, then using this notion, we can construct the examples that I said before. So example, and this example gives a proof for the theorem one. And start with P2 with configuration in this way. Three concurrent line and a conic, which is tangent to the first line and tangent to the second line and transversal to the last line. This is a conic. And if we blow this up very well, then we get this configuration. Get this configuration. Here, bold line is a minus 2 curve, and dotted line is a minus 1 curve.
The tangent point and also the point of the intersection of the line?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Then, if we contract all the minus 2 curves, then we get a singular surface with four singular points. Actually, the types are 2a1 plus 2a3, as you can immediately see. So this is actually a log Dipetro surface of Picard number 1. And blow this point twice, then, of course, this is not a redundant point because this is a rational double point.
You mean the first, the exceptional curves, there is some asymmetry in the picture. Which exceptional curves are the tangency points?
I forgot, but...
I mean, your picture should be symmetric. The conic is tangent above and below, and so how can it be different?
The above part
and the below part.
But,
in the first...
So the blowing up process is not the symmetric one, so you get this one. So it's a special blow ups.
What are you blowing?
So I didn't note down here, so but if you contract the minus one curves, then
I don't know what you're blowing up.
Sorry, I didn't Right down, but if you blow the minus one curves,
I thought you blow up the two tangency points and the point where the three lines meet.
Yeah, so
suggest this?
Here two, here two, here once, and two, two, one, and then and hold nine points. But I forgot the other ones.
And the three lines should be there.
Yeah,
triple point. And it has disappeared.
Ah, yeah. Here. Now I have to blow this up points. And okay. And I don't know the other points. Okay, I just forgot.
The three points I thought plus a fourth one. That's why it's a symmetry. Okay, thanks.
Okay, then. So blow this point twice, then we get this configuration with this curve is now minus four curve, and we get two minus two curves. And according to the classification of according to that proposition, we know that yes, this is a redundant point. Okay, so if we blow this up, then so I will not draw the older pictures, but if we blow this up, then we get another surface, and this is an example of anti-Godard dimension 2, but not the minimal resolution of Tel-Petri surface. And if we blow this point again and again, we get another surface of another minimal resolution of Tel-Petri surface. And if we then also also, this point is a redundant blow up. So if we blow this up, then we get another surface. And this is again a rational surface with anti-Godard dimension 2, but not a minimal resolution of Tel-Petri surface.
How do you know this? How do you know that this is not a minimal resolution?
Because of this theorem. So did I tell it? So actually, the converse of this theorem also holds. Basically, this one. So this theorem holds, and also the converse is true. So the converse says that if we have a Tel-Petri surface with rational singularities and take a minimal resolution, then this should factor y, and this y is with no redundant curve. So if and only condition. So by this theorem, we know that this is not a minimal resolution of Tel-Petri surface, and as we blow this point and go on, then we get the surfaces with the increasing Picard number. So we can prove the theorem one.
This picture must be the Cauley curves with the second component.
Yeah, so I didn't draw it precisely, but
this one.
All right. Thank you. Sorry. This should be correct. Okay, so this is the first construction. And for the second question, I want to write down a theorem. That if the anti-Godard dimension is zero, then take any blow up at a point P, just a single point, and assume that X tilde is Borjigin rational surface. Then the anti-Godard dimension of X tilde is zero if and only if this map phi is a redundant blow up. Okay, so this direction is already already mentioned, and this direction is the new part, and this can be proved using Zariski decomposition and basic properties of Borjigin spaces in with anti-Godard dimension zero. So using this theorem, I will construct the second example. So this example will give you the proof of the second theorem. Here we will use the knowledge on effective C-actions. So consider the configuration in P2 again with four concurrent lines. And another line here. So then blow up the 9 base point. So I can say, so consider this cubic pencil. C square. Consider this cubic pencil where L1 is defined by X and L2 V of Y, L3 V of X plus Y. Large L1 minus Y, 2 V of C. Okay? And this is a cubic pencil, and we have 9 base points, and we blow those up. Then we have this configuration. So the multiplicity here is, see, at this time I wrote down, so 2, 2, 2, although it is obvious from this equation. So you can, using the theorem of Artabani and Lapate, you can show that this is a Borjigin rational surface with anti-Godard dimension 1. And actually this gives an elliptic vibration. The singular fiber is, as you see, 2d4 tilde. Okay. Oh, sorry. So basically I will blow this point or this point. So this picture is too huge, so I will write down in a symbolic way. So this elliptic surface is X here, and consider a blowing up at P. Okay, so it's zero. Blowing up at P, then we can show that this is a Borjigin rational surface with minus xp zero. So any algebraic variety with an effective C star action is a Borjigin space, and since any intersection point of the negative curves are sister fixed point. So if we blow this sister fixed point, then the sister action uniquely extends to the blown up surface. So this xp of zero is also, this also carries an effective sister action. So we know that this is a Moridian rational surface. Okay, and now. So this is just a blow up at P. Blowing up at P. Because I will do it again and again. Okay. So and now I blow this up. Then we have a non. So we have this configuration. This is -3. So if we consider this part, and this is a quotient singularity, and so if we blow this point again and again. And now we can choose the point as a redundant point. Okay. So here we blow up at P, but from here we blow up the redundant point. We can actually this twist is wrong, but after blow this point, we can get the there should be a redundant point because of the configuration. So blow the point and again and again and again. And every surface here is a Moridian rational surface because we blow up the sister fixed point and the antigodal dimension is zero because this point is a redundant point. Okay. And here we take another blow up. This is a blow up at P. At Q, that one. Then we can show that this new surface is now tilde P0. It's now minus infinity. And since this point is sister fixed, this is a Moridian rational surface. So actually this part is hugely rely on the result of Hausen and Schiess, but by using the notion of redundant blow-ups, we can construct it infinitely many. We can construct infinitely many surfaces of that. So after blowing that point up, then we get another redundant point. Then we can do the similar thing. Actually, we can perform the redundant blow-up from here or here. We can do it anyway. So the surfaces in this row are Moridian rational surfaces with antigodal dimension relative infinity, and the Picard numbers are increased by 1 here. So this is the construction. And so let me, because time is almost time's up, so let me finish with one remark. So one remark is, so recent theorem of Okawa, Shinosuke Okawa, says that for any proper surjective map from Moridian space, if this is Moridian space in any dimension, then Y is a Moridian space. But of course the converse is not true. So my question is the converse true for these redundant blow-ups? So it is very easy to show that this is true for antigodal dimension at least 1, and for for the case of zero, we have a partial result. And another question is, actually, almost this example is coming from Lucas-Alpert surfaces. So for generally, let S be a rational surface with quotient singularity of Picard number 1 and take a minimal resolution. Then is S Moridian space? So this I don't know. So if it is true actually, unless KS is ample. So unless this case, this is true. But I don't know the general case. So I'll stop here. Thank you.